Hi everyone, today we are going to study about coordination compounds. Generally we know compounds, the compounds are made up of different elements, but here coordination compounds, how it is, the reactions are the compound, the bonding, we are going to study about that one today. In coordination compound, generally we have to study about ligands. Ligands means which donate a pair of electron or one or more pair of electron to the central metal atom, that is called as ligands. At least it should donate one or more than that lone pair of electron, that is ligands. Okay, here I will give one example, that is K4FeCN6. This is one of the coordination compound. In this one we can see different type of elements, iron, cyanide, potassium, all these things. Here cyanide is the ligand here and the iron is the central metal atom or ion, and which is, this is the coordination sphere and this is, we can consider as one of the cation, and this will have negative charge. The coordination sphere will have always have here in this complex will have negative charge, so it is anionic and this one is cationic. There are different types and classifications of ligands also present there. I will write some of them today. Types. First one is monodentate ligand. Second one is bidentate. Third one is polydentate. And last one is, that is ambidentate ligand. Here first one, that is monodentate. Mono means we can know that is one or single, that is monodentate. That means a ligand which can donate only one pair of electron to the central metal atom, that is monodentate. I can give some examples like cyanide, water, then NO2+. These are the some of the examples for monodentate ligand which can donate only one pair of electron to the central metal atom. For example, I already given the example here, that is cyanide has 6 ligands here, but one cyanide can donate only one pair of electron to the central metal atom. Next, we studied about monodentate ligand. Next we are going to study about bidentate ligand. Bidentate ligand means which can donate two pair of electron to the central metal atom, that is bidentate. Example means we can give COO minus, this is oxalate ion. Here we can see two charges here. These two charges, each one can donate a pair of electron to the central metal atom. So bi means which can donate two pair of electron to the central metal atom or ion. Not only this example, there are so many example for bidentate ligand also there. So I given one example. Next one. Now after that, which we are going to study about polydentate ligand. Polydentate ligand means which can donate more than two pair of electron to the central metal atom or ion. For that one also we can take examples like EDTA means ethylene diamine tetraacetate. Ethylene diamine tetraacetate. If you write the structure, I will write the structure of EDTA now. That is, which contains CH2, and each of them, that ethene group is contain one of the nitrogen to this one, and each nitrogen is containing CH2COO- and CH2COO-, and this nitrogen will also contain CH2COO-, then CH2COO-. You can observe here, that is oxygen atom which are having negative charge here, 4, and nitrogen will also can donate a pair of electron. So it can donate 1 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it can donate 2 pair of electron to the central metal atom. That is, so it is, it can penetrate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is 6. So that is, it is a hexadentate ligand, which can donate 6 ligand. Like that, so many examples also there, not only EDTA, I given one example for this one. Now, after this, I will give another example now, that is about the ambidentate ligand. If you come to the ambidentate ligand, I will take one CNS. Here we can see cyanide and sulfur is present. In this one, if we consider M as a central metal atom or ion, this ligand can donate a pair of electron through cyanide also or through with sulfur also. This one I given as one example, or through sulfur. Yes, sulfur can donate a pair of electron to the central metal atom. Means either sulfur or cyanide can donate a pair of electron to the central metal atom or ion. That is ambidentate ligands. These are the types of ligands we are going to study today. That is monodentate, bidentate, polydentate and ambidentate. These are the types of ligands. After this, we are going to study about the IUPAC name. That is IUPAC means International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. That is nomenclaturing the given compound. Already given one example like K4FeCN6. This is one of the compound. This is hexacyano. Like that only we have to name. There are some methods are there for cationic complex, for anionic complex. For both of them, they are having different type of nomenclature. If we consider this one is a anionic complex, because this complex has negative charge, this one has positive charge. Like that only. So this one here, when we are naming this one as, we have to name through the ligand. So hexacyano. Before naming this one, when we come to this anionic complex, here we have also cation. First we have to name this one is potassium hexacyanoferrate. That is the name of the compound. Potassium hexacyanoferrate is the name of the compound. Like there are so many examples we can give. I will give another one example. Like CONH3 6 times, this is Cl3. And if you come to this complex, this is the complex here, is this will have positive charge and this will have negative charge. How to name this one means, whenever we are naming a complex, first we have to name the ligand. Here ligand here is ammonia. So hexa amine cobalt. After name the cobalt, we have to name the according to the Roman number, that is oxidation state of this one only. From that only we can name. So I will name this one hexa. Because of the presence of 6 ligand, I will name it as hexa amine cobalt 3. We have to name in Roman number. Cobalt 3 means that is the oxidation state. Then present here is, next one is anionic, that is chloride. This is how we name the complexes. Okay, this is the nomenclature of complexes. One K4FeCN6 we nomenclated. Then this one is also we nomenclated. Like that, nomenclaturing the complexes are important, because when we are mentioning a compound, we have to nomenclate it properly. Then only we can write the structure and the formula of the compound. I will give like that only. I will give some of the examples like CONH3 4 times, H2O twice, Cl3. I taken different compound here. Here we can observe two different type of ligands. One is water, another one is ammonia. When we are naming this one, first when we have two different ligands, we have to name according to the alphabetical order. Alphabetical order means when we are naming this one, we name this one as amine. When we are naming this water, that is aqua. Here AM, amine. Amine is aqua. Aqua is water, so both are having alphabetical order AA, but after comes that one is M and here is Q. So we will name first amine. So this is, how do we name this one as? We name this one as tetraamine because of the presence of four ligand. There is tetraamine. Tetraamine diaqua because of the presence of two water molecules. That is diaqua. Diaqua cobalt 3. Cobalt is present here, 3, that is oxidation state in the Roman number, cobalt 3, chloride, yes. So some more examples I can give. The we taken one simple compound, after that we started having different types of ligand. Now I will give another example similarly. I will take any one of the compound now. I will name it separately. This one I will take AgNH3 twice, AgCl twice. Here, when we are naming this one, here we have two type of complexes. That is, one is positive and one is negative here. When we are naming this one, we have to name through always with the ligand. So this one is diamine silver. Or we have to name it when we are having positive charge. When we are naming a cationic, that is important. When we are naming a anionic, that is important. Here, when we are Ag, here is the central metal atom. That is, we have to name it as silver. That is, we have to name it as a silver here. So diamine silver 1. Oxidation state of this one is 1, plus charge, negative charge. So after that we are naming an anionic complex, so we have to name it as, I will continue here only, that is dicyanide. When we are naming an anionic complex, we have to name it as dicyanide argentate. Always anionic complex will end with ATE, argentate. Then it has having an oxidation state, that is 1. Okay, thank you. I think you have understood something from this class and the nomenclature of the compounds and the types of ligands. Okay, thank you so much.